What do we mean when we talk about climate change? And there's really two parts to it. Is the climate changing? The more complicated question is, are humans causing the climate change? Teaching climate change to 17 and 18 year olds can be a challenge. So one of the things that's a big advantage for me is I bring a lot of credibility to the subject. I've done my homework and I've worked really hard to educate myself on the subject. So I try not to present conclusions. I present them with the best evidence I know that's out there, and I try to let them draw their own conclusions from the evidence. The activity that we just did at the Kettle Pond is based on the work I did at the Tulik Field Station last summer. One of my responsibilities as a PolarTREC teacher was to take the pretty complex science that my researchers were working on and adapt it to lessons for the high school classroom. So what we were doing there was an activity that I designed to make it easy for teachers to try to measure changes in carbon dioxide levels. So I took a pretzel barrel, cut it in half, and drilled a hole in the top to put the CO2 sensor in. And so that then serves as a chamber where we can place that on a lake surface or we can place it on the ground and see if carbon dioxide in that chamber is increasing over time and collect data that students can use and hopefully increase their understanding of how the carbon cycle works.
Bruce has been really cool, and he did this thing with us today on the carbon cycle and how he's like, this is what I want you, my kids, to know before they come to me. And so it kind of makes me think, okay, I need to start setting the foundation, and what is the base of this foundation. And I feel like I have the knowledge from Bruce. One of the things I wanted to know more about was the instruments when I came here, and so it's cool to have those hands-on instruments that I could purchase for my class.
It's a hands-on learning what this class has done. We've had so many hands-on experiences, and standing in front of the evidence of what is happening in this dynamic landscape that we're living in. I think that's the most important part, is to experience it for yourself.
The teachers in this course are much more diverse than I had expected. I expected environmental science teachers, and we have art teachers, we have third grade teachers, we have all kinds of teachers who have very different ideas about how they're going to incorporate climate change into their curriculum. So I've been listening a lot to them and trying to understand what they're looking for here, and then try to present them with some science that they can then integrate into the lessons that they teach their students. They can be part of the solution. They're going to have to be part of the solution if the problem is going to get solved. So I think it's really important for people to have a good understanding of the science behind the problem before we can talk about solutions.